The President of the United States at the White House at his America Products meeting is now taking questions from the media. Let's watch.
Well, that's just a very racist statement, somebody that would say that. So Speaker Pelosi said, make America white again. Let me tell you, that's a very racist statement. I'm surprised she'd say that. John, go ahead.
Going back to fix the problems, what were you talking about?
Well, they're very unhappy. I'm watching them. All they do is complain. So all I'm saying is, if they want to leave, they can leave, John. They can leave. I mean, I look at Omar. I don't know. I never met her. I hear the way she talks about Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda has killed many Americans. She said, you can hold your chest out. You can, when I think of America, when I think of Al-Qaeda, I can hold my chest out. When she talked about the World Trade Center being knocked down, some people, you remember the famous some people. These are people that, in my opinion, hate our country. Now, you can say what you want, but get a list of all of the statements they've made. And all I'm saying that if they're not happy here, they can leave. They can leave. And you know what? I'm sure that there'll be many people that won't miss them.
But they're American citizens.
But they have to love. They have to love our country. They're Congress people, and I never used any names.
Are you
but these
okay
are people. Quiet, quiet, quiet,
racist,
quiet, quiet.
Are you okay with people
quiet
thinking your tweets are racist, sir?
Quiet. These
I'm
are people
question,
that
please.
If they don't like it here, they can leave. And I'd be, I don't know who's going to miss them, but I guess some people will.
Sir,
one of them is polling. One of them is polling at eight. One of them is polling at 8%. One of them is polling at 8%. So when I hear people speaking about how wonderful Al-Qaeda is, when I hear people talking about some people with the World Trade Center, some people, no, not some people, much more than some people. When I hear the statements that they've made, and in one case you have somebody that comes from Somalia, which is a failed government, a failed state, who left Somalia, who ultimately came here, and now is a congresswoman who's never happy, says horrible things about Israel, hates Jews. It's very simple. And if the Democrats want to wrap their bows around this group of four people, one of them kept Amazon out of New York, tens of thousands of jobs, would have been a great thing. And she kept Amazon from going, would have been a good deal. I mean, could he have made better? Maybe. But tens of thousands of jobs, and New York has not been the same since that happened. It's really hurt New York and New York City. Amazon was going to go. They were going to relocate a major section of their business in New York. She kept them out. That was a terrible thing she did. A terrible thing she did. So here's the story. Here's the story. I see them complaining. They're complaining constantly. I watched Lindsey Graham today on Fox and Friends talking about the same subject, and frankly, even stronger than what I'm saying. He said they're communists. I'm saying that they're socialists, definitely. As to whether or not they're communists, I would think they might be. But this isn't what our country is about. Nevertheless, they're free to leave if they want. And if they want to leave, that's fine. And if they want to stay, that's fine. But the people have to know. And politicians can't be afraid to take them on. A politician that hears somebody where we're at war with Al-Qaeda and sees somebody talking about how great Al-Qaeda is, pick out her statement, that was Omar, how great Al-Qaeda is. When you hear that, and we're losing great soldiers to Al-Qaeda, when you see the World Trade Center gets knocked down, and you see the statements made about the World Trade Center, all the death and destruction, I'll tell you what, I'm not happy with them. And it's very easy to be say, oh, gee, well, it's okay. If weak politicians want to say, and the Democrats in this case, if they want to gear their wagons around these four people, I think they're going to have a very tough election, because I don't think the people of the United States will stand for it.
Mr. President? Mr. President? Mr. President? Mr. President?
John, go ahead.
Mr. President,
go ahead, John.
Let me see if I can sum up sort of what people are talking about here.
Does it concern you that that tweet was seen as racist? Lindsey Graham said, encouraged you to aim higher. And does it trouble you?
He didn't say about that. He just said, don't go. See, I disagree with Lindsey.
Okay, but can
these
I finish?
Are congressmen. Right. What am I supposed to do? Just wait for senators? No.
And does
these
it?
Are four. So I disagree with Lindsey on that. That was the only thing.
Right.
He said, aim higher, shoot higher. What am I going to do? Wait till we get somebody else in a higher position, higher office?
Sure.
These are people that hate our country.
But
hey, John. They hate our country.
But
they hate it, I think, with a passion.
Okay.
Now, it's possible I'm wrong. The voter will decide. But when I hear the way they talk about our country, when I hear the anti-Semitic language they use, when I hear the hatred they have for Israel and the love they have for enemies like Al-Qaeda, then you know what? I will tell you that I do not believe this is good for the Democrat Party. Certainly, it's not the party that I've known over the years.
But can I just
Mr. President, where should they? Mr. President, where should
they? Does it concern you that many people saw that tweet as racist and that white nationalist groups are finding common cause with you on that point?
It doesn't concern me because many people agree with me. And all I'm saying, they want to leave, they can leave. Now, it doesn't say leave forever. It says leave if you want. But what it says, what that says is, if they're not happy with the United States, if they're doing nothing but criticizing us all the time, you see these people walking down criticizing the United States, we just hit the highest stock market in history. All of these incredible manufacturers that are in, these are great business people, they employ many people, and we have workers with us too. They're having the best year they've ever had. Can I say that? Is that a correct statement? So, and they're hiring more people than they've ever had, and more people are making a good living than they've ever had. We just hit 27,000 plus on the Dow. It's the highest the stock market has ever been. And you have to go by the election, because the market started going up the day after I won. You know, they like to add all of that tremendous gain. They like to try and give it to Obama. The fact is, if I would have lost, the stock market would crash. And if these people that I watch in those debates ever got their hands on the United States government, 401ks, the values of your company, everything else that we talk about we're so proud of, it's down the tubes. People will lose their money. They'll lose their wealth. You'll have a crash like you've never seen before. And I'm really good at this stuff. I know what I'm talking about. Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Why didn't your